Deputy Mary Lou MacDonald. Deputy MacDonald.
Gurmagut Cian Corla. Follow that, as they say. Taoiseach, I want to raise with you in this very important week the issue of the Brexit negotiations. And we know that we will see tomorrow and the next day the text that you say will give legal effect to the agreement struck between the European Union and the British government last December. You'll recall that at the time of its publication, we acknowledged that some political progress had been made, but we raised a series of contradictions inherent in that agreement at the time. And I want to just, for the purposes of the record, place them again before the House. The first contradiction, Taoiseach, was the claim that there would be no hard border on the island of Ireland, but yet that the North would be taken out of the customs union and the single market. Number two was the assertion that there would be no threat to the Good Friday Agreement, against the fact that there are 142 areas, at least, of all Ireland cooperation that could be adversely affected by Brexit. Contradiction number three was the claim that there would be no erosion in the rights of citizens living in the North, as against the fact that the British are determined to withdraw from the jurisdiction of the European Court of Justice. And number four, that the North voted to remain in the European Union, and the fact that that decision has been set aside by the British government, the DUP and others. Taoiseach, in the conversion of December's political agreement into a legally binding withdrawal text, it's absolutely critical that this set of contradictions are resolved, because that's the only way that you will bring real clarity and real certainty for our people, for our all-Ireland economy, and indeed for our agreements. So that means that the text has to explicitly state that there will be no Brexit border on the island. And the only way to guarantee this, as you well know, is for the North to remain inside the customs union and inside the single market. The text must explicitly protect the Good Friday Agreement in all of its parts. And it has to make clear, in substance, that there will be no loss of rights for citizens. I know, Taoiseach, that the Taoiseach that met with Michel Barnier in Brussels yesterday. The Minister has seen the draft legal text. He's quoted widely today saying that he is more than satisfied that, in fact, the Irish government and the EU are of one mind on the draft text. So can I ask you, therefore, Taoiseach, have those four contradictions been resolved? You said before that this state should not, this country cannot take a leap into the dark.
Thank you, Deputy.
When dealing with matters connected with Brexit. I absolutely agree with you. Can you confirm, therefore, that the text we will see resolves all of the issues that I have set out and, in real terms, represents the legal protection and guarantees that
Thank
we need?
Thank you, Deputy. Taoiseach.
Thanks, Deputy. I'm satisfied it does. The withdrawal agreement, or rather the draft withdrawal agreement, will be published in Brussels tomorrow at 12 noon. I'm not at liberty, obviously, to detail it here today, but it will be available for people to see at 12 noon tomorrow. The Taoiseach met with Michel Barnier yesterday to indicate our satisfaction with the text, and I spoke by phone with Prime Minister May last night. You'll know the background to all of this. The United Kingdom voted to leave the European Union. Almost immediately after that, we sought an assurance from the United Kingdom that there would be no hard border, that everything would be done possible to avoid a hard border between Northern Ireland and Ireland. And we got that verbal assurance last year. We then sought to have that written down in black and white and made into a political agreement. And we got that political agreement last December. And since then, we have sought to turn the text in black and white, the political agreement, the political commitment given to us in black and white, into a legal text, which forms a protocol to the withdrawal agreement. And I think you will see that legal text tomorrow, and I'm satisfied that it puts down in law how we can avoid a hard border between Northern Ireland and Ireland. I should say that, as I said back in December, there are three options as to how we can do that. The first is in the context of a new close relationship between the UK and the EU. That is absolutely our preference. We don't want a border between the north and the south any more than we want a border in the Irish Sea or between east and west. That is still our preference. Option B is the British bespoke solutions, which they have yet to outline, but we look forward to seeing them once they have done that. And option C is the fallback option, or the last resort, as Prime Minister May prefers to describe it, and that is outlined in legal form in the withdrawal agreement tomorrow. But I should say, the agreement being produced tomorrow, or rather the withdrawal agreement being published tomorrow in Brussels, is a draft text, and we can't automatically assume they will be acceptable to the United Kingdom or acceptable to all the parties in Northern Ireland. So we could have an interesting few weeks ahead of us, as we did back in December. It will, of course, need to become a legal text by October this year.
Mr. MacDonald.
Thank you. Taoiseach, can I therefore assume that the text allows for the North remaining within the customs union and the single market? Can I ask you a question as direct as that? Because I recall last December you sought to assure people that the agreement struck was cast iron, that it was watertight. And of course, in the days that followed the announcement, it became abundantly clear that it was anything but watertight or cast iron. And in fact, doubt was shed as to the strength of the agreement. This is actually quite straightforward. In order to protect the Good Friday Agreement, to protect the livelihoods, jobs, the commerce and economy of the island, we need the North to remain within the customs union and to remain within the single market. And I would like you to tell us very directly, Taoiseach, whether or not the text that we will see tomorrow allows and provides and legally underpins that.
Thank you, Deputy. Taoiseach.
Thanks, Deputy. You will see the text tomorrow. It will be published at 12 noon. I'm not at liberty, for reasons I'm sure you'd appreciate, to go through that here today, but I will organise briefings for the party leaders tomorrow so that all of the party leaders or their spokespeople are fully appraised of it as soon as we're at liberty to talk about its contents. The term that appears in the joint report and the political agreement that was made back in December is that in that backstop scenario, in that option C scenario, the United Kingdom will ensure that Northern Ireland maintains full regulatory alignment with the European Union, thus allowing for us to avoid a hard border. And the protocol to the withdrawal agreement, which will be published tomorrow, details exactly how that can be done.